Welcome back to another Slightly Redneck video. Working with some eggs today, getting ready to do some incubation, so I thought I'd do a quick video here to show you how to prepare your eggs for incubation to ensure the best hatch rate possible. So stay tuned and we'll get right into that. Okay, the first step then in getting your eggs ready for incubation is to get them up to room temperature. If you've been watching my other videos on how to store your eggs, you'll want to remove them from the cooler, set them on the counter, and just let them warm up to room temperature. Get a bowl of water and get that warmed up to room temperature as well. And what we're going to do here is float test our eggs. It's a pretty easy process here really, but this is going to help you determine which eggs you can incubate, which ones you can't. Pretty simple, just do it real nice and easy. Take an egg, you're just going to place it in a bowl of water, and you're going to set it down there. And you can see this egg floats flat on the bottom, and I don't know if you can tell that on camera, but it's just sitting on the bottom of the bowl. So it's a good egg. So I'm going to take it out, put it back in my carton, and let it dry. Take another egg. That one floats flat on the bottom as well. If any of your eggs are floating on the top, then you're going to discard them. Let me get a couple of different eggs here and see if I can find something different. Okay, now see that egg kind of turns a little bit and it stands up on end. So I'm going to let it set in there for a few minutes. And it may be hard to see on camera, but there's a few little bubbles coming out of it. So I'm going to let it sit there for just a few minutes. It'll rehydrate itself, it'll soak some of that water up, and when it lays down flat on the bottom, then I'll be good to remove it. So I'm going to leave it in there for just a minute or two and get another egg. Okay, that egg is good. Ready to go. That egg is good, ready to go. Now what's happening here is your eggs are stored, they'll lose some of the moisture inside, it'll evaporate, and that's why they're floating upright like that. They're not floating high in the water, they're sitting on the bottom, but they're sitting kind of at an angle, and I know that's really hard to see on camera, but they're standing up kind of on end. So give me an idea with a fresh egg right here. If this is the bottom of the bowl, instead of laying on its side like that, they're sitting up on end kind of like this. So what I'm doing is I'm just letting them sit in the water. They'll soak back up some of that water, some of that moisture, and eventually they'll lay down on their side, and that's what I'm looking for, is for them to lay down on the bottom to rehydrate the egg to get plenty of moisture for the chick to hatch. And you can see that egg bounced right up to the top, and it's floating, so it's probably a discard egg. It's not gonna hatch. So again, put it in there, and it floats on the top. It's not even on the bottom. It's not completely at the top, but this egg is going to be discarded then. It's no good. Okay. Hopefully you can see through there. There's a little bit of a better view. You can see this one egg right here is standing up on its end instead of laying down. The rest of them are all laying down on their sides. So these are all good eggs that are laying down on their sides. I'm going to go ahead and take them out. I'll leave this one in here for up to about 5 minutes to see if it'll rehydrate and lay down on the side. What I'm looking for is to lay down like that, instead of floating up on end like that. So we'll give it a few minutes and see if it rehydrates, about 5 minutes. And if it does, great, go ahead and incubate it. If it doesn't, I'm gonna go ahead and toss it out. The biggest concern with incubating an egg like this is that the chick inside won't have enough moisture to hatch and it'll end up dying in the shell. And then it spreads bacteria to the rest of your eggs and it can really destroy your hatch rate that way. So that's really the biggest concern and the biggest reason for doing a float test and checking is to get any eggs that you're pretty sure will not incubate out of there and to keep bacteria down in your incubator. Okay, once you've got all your eggs float tested, you've got them back in the egg cartons here, you're going to take again your mixture. If you've been watching my eggs or my video on how to store them, it's 50% Listerine, just the regular gold Listerine, and 50% water. And I'm going to spray them down one more time real good. And this is going to take care of bacteria. I've found in my experience that that is the biggest thing. If you can get the temperature right, you're going to have a good hatch rate. The humidity is not as important, but if you can keep bacteria down, get the temperature right, then that's going to help. Now all I'm going to do, let these things dry. Once they air dry, they're ready to go in the incubator. From this point on, do not spray them down again. Once they're in the incubator, you do not want to get them wet. That's going to create steam and it could kill your eggs off. All right, that's really about all there is to preparing your eggs and getting them ready for incubation. So make sure to stick around, hit the subscribe button below. I'm doing a whole series on incubating eggs. You'll be able to keep up with those videos and hopefully it will help you get the best hatch rate possible out of your eggs. Again, thanks for watching, and as always, God bless.